In part two, we're going to focus on the Angular CLI. The Angular CLI was introduced in the ng-conf by Mike Rocky, and he's the contributor to Angular2. So in this part, we're going to try to use the CLI to create the Tour of Heroes application that is shown as an example on the Angular2 website, that's on angular.io. So in the angular.io site, it uses it doesn't use the CLI directly, but Mike Brocky had demonstrated the process for using the CLI to create the application. So if you look at the documentation here, there's some steps for installing the CLI. So I've already installed Angular-CLI here. And in the README file for the Angular2 workshop, I've added the steps for using the CLI. So in here, I have some of the steps for using the CLI. So I'm going to use it off of the README file that I have, because the formatting is not great on the GitHub. So I'm going to actually fix the formatting, but I'm going to use it off the README for now. So I have a folder called part 2. So in part 2, I have an empty folder, and I can start by ensuring that I have the CLI. So first I'll say ng new doh, ng new doh, and set the prefix to doh. So what that's doing right now is essentially setting up the entire tree, and it's also setting up the npm packages, or downloading the npm packages which are specified for a Angular2 project. So all the dependencies are getting installed. Now, just to understand how the CLI works, we can take a look again on the CLI website. And here you can generate a scaffold using ng-generate. And the scaffold can generate components, directives, pipes, and services. So a route is generated using ng-generate-route, and you can use ng-build to build the artifacts. The tests are defined in the spec files, and they can be run using ng-test. There's also end-to-end tests, which can be run via protractor. And the linting and formatting can be done using ng-lint and ng-format. So here in auto-completion, we can add ng-completion to our .bashrc, which might be useful to do. And I'll probably add that. Well, there's probably some bug in there. I'm going to file that as a bug later. Anyway, so this is still in beta, just since they just announced it. So there's probably some bugs in there. Anyway, so once this project is generated here, doh, we can remove this .git that's on there because we don't need the submodule there. Now, it has generated most of the structure that we need. So if you look at the doh folder, it has the source folder, which contains the app folder, which contains the doh component, .html, this doh component, CSS placeholder, the index.ts, and environment.ts. So what we need to do now is open our readme file, and we can test the generated files. So run ng test with no watch to see what happens. So it's testing it in the browser and it ran successfully, so looks like the tests are running fine. And the dist folder is now generated as a result of running those tests. Anyway, so the next step is to create a hero model. So we can say ng generate. Oh, we have to source the bash RC in order to get auto completion to work. Ng generate. Yeah, that's not auto completing. So ng generate class shared / hero model. And what that does is it generates the spec as well as the model. So under shared, we have the TS file for the hero model and the spec for that file, which this is what runs when we run the tests. So in order to implement our hero class or declare the hero, we need to add some properties to our hero. So we can add the ID, the number, and the name to the hero. And once that's done, we can add the service to access the hero. So you can say ng generate service shared / hero, and what that does is generates the service for our hero and as well as the service spec. So in our service for the hero, we can add the methods we need. So first we need to import hero from our model. So if you go back to the hero service.ts, we can import the hero model. And just to check the syntax here, at from .slash hero dot model. And this is supposed to autocomplete, but let's see how it does. So yeah, it does autocomplete. Okay, so the service now has the hero object, and we can add our constructor, or we can add the getHeroes method below the constructor. So in our service, we can add this getHeroes method. It's not indenting the way I want it to. So let me indent it right. Just go to edit, line, re-indent. Yeah, that's better. Now, in our getHero method, we can return the list of heroes and filter by ID. So again, I need to indent this right. So notice that this is TypeScript, so the syntax may not be exactly what you're used to in JavaScript ES5. Okay, so the next step is to add the list of heroes and to map them with the index. So in our hero service, we can add the heroes array, and I've added some sample data here and some sample names. This is not real data. So now that we have our heroes map, we can add some CSS to format the markup. So once our CSS is there, we can add the link which routes to the dashboard. So in our tour of heroes component.html, we can add this router link. So after that, we can add the route to the dashboard. So back to the CLI and add the route to dashboard. So that generated these additional dashboard files. So if we look at dashboard, it's added the dashboard .component.html, the dashboard component.css, and the dashboard.component.spec, .ts. So in the ts file, we can add our hero service import. So inside the dashboard, or sorry, inside the component.ts, we need to add the inside our toh component.ts, we can add our hero service import like that there, and inside in our providers, inside the toh component.ts, we can add the hero service as a provider. So just add the providers. Right here. Now it seems to be complaining that the router providers are not available. So let's see if we can add the provider import. So inside our providers here. Okay, so now that error is gone away. Okay, so now we can format our dashboard using some CSS. And this CSS is basically taken from the Tour of Heroes example in here. So again, it's nothing special, just the formatting for the dashboard. So we can use that to format our heroes page. So dashboard.component.css. Now under the HTML for the dashboard, we can add the list of heroes right there and remove that header. Okay, so now we have a list of heroes on the dashboard. Now we can add some imports to the dashboard component. So just add these imports to the dashboard component. .ts. So add the router and add the hero and the hero service. And we can add the property in the dashboard component. So inside the dashboard component right here, we have the heroes property. Again, some indentation issues, so I'll just re-indent, which was better. So inside the constructor, we can inject our hero service and the router. So in our dashboard component constructor, we inject the hero service as well as the router. And inside the onInit, the ng-onInit, we can use promises to get the list of heroes. So use the hero service to get the heroes, and in the promise return the array of heroes. Okay, so now that that's ready, we can build the app. So back to the CLI and type ng build. So there was a issue with ng build. So it said could not start. It's looking for could not find this module. So whenever it's missing a certain module, you can import that module into the package JSON. So let's look at the package JSON. So the one that it's missing is at Angular/testing. So in order to fix that, we can say npm install at Angular/testing --save. So once that completes, if we go back to our package JSON, we have this Angular testing dependency added to it. Just for safety, we can run npm install. And if it's missing any dependencies, it should pull it down. Okay, so now it's got the dependency resolved, so let's run ng-build again. Okay, so it built successfully. Now in our README, we should have so we need to run ng-test. Now this might be buggy right now, so it might fail the test, but let's see if it runs. Okay, so it started the browser in the background and it's running. Yeah, it's running the test and I guess it's still running. Yeah, it's still running. Oh, maybe it errored out. So, yeah, there is an error somewhere in here. So, we're going to close the test. So back to running the app, so ng-serve. Okay, so the app is now running on 4200. And if we refresh the browser. Okay, so let's click on dashboard. And yeah, it's showing us the list of heroes. The formatting is off, but that's a CSS issue which we can fix. Anyway, so thanks for watching. We'll continue in the next part. Bye for now.